Mountain View, California is home to hundreds of technology firms, from NASA's supercomputing division to tech giant Google, which alone employs 20,000 people here. The city's unemployment rate is 2.5%, half the national average, and the median household income tops $100,000 a year. But there are perils to this prosperity, says Mountain View Mayor Pat Showalter.
So many people have come here that their rents, just because of supply and demand, have gone through the roof.
The median rent for an apartment or house is $4,390 a month, a 54% jump since 2012.
It doesn't matter whether you make, you make $100,000 or not. You haven't planned for a 54% rent increase. Then it's caused a lot of people to be displaced.
A small but growing number of the city's 80,000 residents are now living in recreational vehicles, vans, and cars, like these on the street next to a park.
This is my home, I'm happy here.
59-year-old Scott Whaley moved out of his Mountain View apartment into a minivan last November when he lost his job as a property manager.
I just moved into my van. I said, until I can find a place. This is my bedroom back here.
Whaley now lives in this used 1997 RV he bought for $10,000, depleting his savings.
Yes, I would love to have a home, however, this is my home. I'm not homeless.
A couple miles away, across from an office park, Marcia Chrislieb also makes her home in an RV.
And this is bigger than some of the studios that you've looked at.
It is.
Even though she earns $65,000 a year as an environmental consultant for NASA, Chrislieb says it's not enough to support her and husband Dennis, who's looking for work.
The only apartment we've looked at so far that looks like it was in a safe neighborhood for almost $2,400 a month. So that's a huge portion of the salary, and we're just going to have to give up other conveniences. I still can only afford the things I could afford when I was making minimum wage, because everything else goes to rent.
The Chrislieb's try to park their RV at a proper campsite, but the only facility in Mountain View that provided power and water hookups is now a construction site. It closed last year after a developer bought the property to build million-dollar townhouses. This summer, the city of Mountain View counted 126 vehicles being used as homes.
It's very difficult to get good numbers because homeless individuals are often trying to remain hidden.
Tom Myers is executive director of Mountain View's Community Services Agency.
People living in vehicles to this type of degree and number is completely new and completely unheard of in this community. So people living in their vehicles is something that we are really, as a community, ill-equipped to be able to handle.
Delmi Ruiz is preparing dinner in the cramped RV she moved into with her husband and three kids last November. Ruiz has worked as a housekeeper in Mountain View for 10 years. Her husband cleans offices. She says the landlord of her last apartment raised their rent three times in the year before they moved out.
The rent started increasing, and we were no longer able to pay for it.
So why do you stay in Mountain View?
Because we've always lived in Mountain View. Before, it was possible to live here and pay for rent because it was cheap, but it's become impossible to live here.
For other displaced residents who choose to stay in Mountain View, even an RV is too expensive. Dwayne Goldstein makes $30,000 a year as a pathology lab technician, but he lived in this rented minivan for 2 months. It was retrofitted with a mattress and window curtains. He says it was cheaper and had more privacy than the boarding house where he'd lived before.
$200 a week for a bunk bed in a room with five other bunk beds.
He saved money, but it wasn't easy.
I really had to sit down and be honest with myself and say, could I get up every day and take the necessary discipline to not eat after a certain hour, make sure that I charge my devices every evening, get up in time to, if I need to move the van because of parking tickets and so forth, do that. On top of the everyday rigors of, getting dressed and being presentable for my employment.
To keep himself clean and presentable, for $35 a month, Goldstein joined a 24-hour gym with showers.
It's usually cold in the evening times when I go to the gym or when I come in, so you know I keep my sweaters, and this is my laundry, which I'll take to the laundromat once a week.
For those living in vehicles who can't afford a gym membership, the nonprofit Dignity on Wheels offers mobile shower and laundry services. For his part, Goldstein has moved back into a shared apartment. Some Mountain View residents living in vehicles can easily afford an apartment, but choose to save money and rough it. Brandon, who's 23 and declined to give his last name, earns $175,000 a year as a software engineer. We agreed not to name his employer. He sleeps in this windowless moving truck parked a few blocks from his office in Mountain View. He says he has all the amenities he needs at work.
So there are gyms on the campus where I work. There are showers at the gyms, naturally. They have cafes where you can grab breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So I thought it didn't make a lot of sense for me to replicate that whole environment at home, especially when I wouldn't even be taking advantage of it.
Brandon's been living in his truck for more than a year and writing a blog about his experience called From Inside the Box.
It's like a substantial sum of money that I would have just been effectively burning on rent. And you know, there's no equity being built up on anything.
The savings helped Brandon pay off his $20,000 student loan debt. He's now maxing out contributions to his retirement plan.
A lot of people are blaming the high cost of housing on the tech companies and on the tech workers.
Yeah, you have all these high paid workers coming into the area. People or landlords know they can charge more for rent. Yeah, I mean, it ends up becoming totally unsustainable and intractable for people who don't have the sort of resources that these tech workers have. So I think they're perfectly justified in blaming us.
As the largest employer in Mountain View, Google recognizes its high salaries have contributed to an inflated housing market. Rebecca Prozan is a public policy manager at the company's San Francisco office.
Obviously, our footprint creates pressure on housing and transportation. But that pressure isn't just tech, it's not just Google. It is all the industries that are creating the economy of the Bay Area. We all have to work together to figure out what we are going to look like and how we're going to live.
Prozan didn't want to address published reports about a handful of its employees living in vehicles to save money.
I think the issue is that we don't necessarily want to comment on our employees participating in those activities.
But, she said, Google is committed to addressing the problem of homelessness in the Bay Area. In Mountain View alone, the company has pledged $1 million for a rapid rehousing program.
This specific grant will work to help those who are on the fringes, either about to lose their home or about to get into a home, in the form of time-limited payments, motel rooms, things of that nature, to really make sure that people are able to have a home and not live in a car.
Several California cities have prohibited people from living in vehicles parked on public streets. But in 2014, a federal appeals court struck down a Los Angeles law that it said, quote, opens the door to discriminatory enforcement against the homeless and the poor. That caused LA and other cities to rescind their bans. Certainly, Mountain View officials hear their share of complaints.
I have mixed feelings. You know, I feel sorry for the people that are there, but it's kind of, we pay a ton of rent to live in our building, so it's kind of like a lot of garbage and kind of stuff around.
The sites I saw were mostly clean, and people living in vehicles say the police have been tolerant. Mountain View Mayor Pat Showalter says her approach is to offer help, not punishment.
The intent is to get everybody the shelter that they need. It just doesn't seem like impounding somebody's vehicle, charging them many, many dollars to get it back when they don't have much money to start with. And it just seems like, how does that help? What's the value of that?